Emily!
Oh, good Lord.
What are you doing here? We heard there was a man in your room.
That deviant is attacking her.
Not exactly resisting.
It's proof that Xander is a dangerous influence on
Edward, Edward, put a sock in it. Would you explain what's going on, please?
Isn't it obvious? They're groping on the bed.
It's not exactly a criminal offense.
You must have come in through that window. Illegal entry, young man.
You
think yet another crime.
Forget what you did to Emily.
Wait, let's just hear
Quiet
Emily.
All of you.
Thank you, Dr. Quarterman. There's something I'd like to say, please.
Get off my daughter's bed. Get out of here.
Not until you hear me out.
Nothing happened, Dad,
nothing
okay?
Nothing will happen. Young man, I have you dead to rights for breaking and entering.
What are you doing?
I'm calling the police, of course.
You stay away from that phone.
Somebody has to draw the line around here.
Anyone calls the police, it'll be us.
Did you forget about that document you signed about that, about Xander? Did you?
That's the thanks I get for trying to protect
Let's
my
go.
Granddaughter.
What do you say we take another look at that?
I will not be bullied. Alan, Let's go. Protect
the
yourself
man.
From
Let's
that
go.
Twin
There we go.
Mom. Thank you for defending me to Grandfather. We're gonna go.
We're not finished yet.
I don't
Happy? Yet another family gathering that you've cut me out of?
Gathering? You ratted out a teenage girl and her boyfriend and the family's upstairs making their lives miserable? You call that a gathering?
How was I supposed to know they'd go running off like some hysterical posse?
Oh, I think you have a sneaking suspicion.
Yeah, well, it sure worked for Alan, didn't it? He didn't hesitate a minute. He just went marching right up those stairs to take care of the little girl that he loves.
So you told on Emily because that's really the father that you want. Right, Skye?
Well, Skye, nice stunt you just pulled.
Pay no attention to him, dear. You did us all a big favor, and I, for one, am very grateful for your efforts.
Yeah, I'm sure it was really labor-intensive to walk all the way down the stairs just to rat out my little sister and her boyfriend.
Skye sounded the alarm just in time for us to save Emily from the clutches of that deviant.
I'm sure her motives were as pure as the driven snow.
How was I supposed to know that Emily was entertaining?
Watch it. It's my little sister you're talking about.
What does that make me?
It makes you a very welcome addition to this family, dear.
Depends on who you ask.
Is it my fault that this young woman has more sense than the rest of my grandchildren all put together?
If you're buying into Grandfather's phony sincerity, then you're a bigger fool than I thought.
He's smart enough to watch out for Emily. He seems to be the only one in this family who cares if she ends up being pregnant like Ray here. Tell him what happens to young girls who go too far.
Edward, outside, now.
Was it something I said?
Try everything. Now it's my turn. I want you both to know how much I love your daughter.
I don't want to hear this.
Alan?
Listen, Emily told me what her grandfather did, how he set me up just to keep me away from her.
What Edward did was completely wrong.
No, but he did worse than frame me. He blackmailed Emily. She had to cut me off just to keep me from being arrested.
We know all this.
No, you don't. When Emily finally explained to me, I was angry until I realized that it wasn't her fault. So I came here tonight to ask for her forgiveness.
Which I gave.
And I won't let Emily's grandfather or anyone else get between us again. I love Emily, and she loves me, and nothing can change that.
Nothing.
All right. You've been honest with me, and I'll be perfectly honest with you back. I don't like you, Xander. You are constantly involved in criminal activities. You associate with dangerous people, including Sonny Corinthos. But worst of all, you have repeatedly put Emily's life in danger.
Dad, can you just listen?
You need to hear me out. I love my daughter, and I don't want to lose her. Now, obviously, Emily has found something worthwhile in you because she has stuck around for such a long time. Now, I don't approve of what my father did to the both of you. It was cruel and unjust. The worst thing that anybody in a family can do is interfere with two people who love each other. It causes serious damage. I know what that's like. Because my father caused me to lose something very precious years ago. I don't want history to repeat itself.
Are you saying what I think you are?
I'm still not happy about this, Emily. And I will worry about you as much as ever, but I will not stand in your way. And I'm not going to allow anybody in this family to do it either.
You're the best.
Just wait. You haven't heard our conditions yet. You will be allowed to see Xander, but only with our permission.
No problem.
I'm glad to hear it.
Is that it?
One more thing. Non-negotiable. You have to move home until you go away to college.
Is that okay with you?
Oh, Emily, it'll be wonderful to have you come home. I've missed you so much.
I've missed you too. Look, can we have a minute alone so I can say goodnight?
No.
Okay.
Whatever game you're playing, Emily is off limits.
Or I'll have you to answer to?
No. I'm just the start. AJ here, he makes a bad enemy. And his brother Jason? Well, let's just say he lacks the mental capacity to always make the right decision. You never know when he's gonna go off.
Especially when he realizes that his new sister is hurting Emily. You see, he's very protective of Emily.
He happens to be a mob enforcer.
Which will make things very awkward for you.
Are you done with the bullying routine?
You haven't seen bullying yet, and you don't want to.
You seem to be forgetting something. I'm the one who was wronged in the first place. I was robbed of my place in this family, and I intend to get my fair share.
Whatever, knock yourself out, all right? Lie, scheme, manipulate, it doesn't matter. We're used to that. You just stay away from Emily.
If you have any illusions that I'm gonna go run off whimpering in fear, never to be seen or heard from again, I have news. I'm here to stay. Now, either you boys can get with the program or you can be left in the dust, that's entirely up to you. And if you don't believe me, why don't you put in a few phone calls to Pine Valley and Landview? I'm sure the people there will tell you what I'm capable of. I'm starting to sound like a Quartermain by the minute.
Ew.
I know what you're trying to do, Edward, and I'm not letting you get away with it. You make any progress with Ned and AJ?
I told them to get out of my way or prepare to be run over. Is that the kind of progress you mean?
I like your style.
That woman is going to cause all kinds of trouble.
She already is. She's got us agreeing with one another.
And it's only the beginning.
I got an idea.
Am I supposed to applaud?
Funny. Anyway, I think maybe you should go back to work at ELQ so you can keep an eye on her.
Absolutely not.
So much for us agreeing.
So, did you lock Emily up? You know, I'm going to have the gardener cut down that blasted tree first thing in the morning, and I think we'll just seal that window over.
None of this is needed, Father. We've handled the situation.
How? Have you grounded Emily for the rest of the school year? I was thinking that if we sent her on one of those exchange programs for the summer, maybe to Spain or even China, that would be good.
Sorry, Grandfather, but my parents have actually decided to trust me.
With restrictions.
Which I agree to.
Why is that deviant holding her hand?
Because we're allowing them to date.
Oh, have you lost your mind? Don't you realize the depths that he could drag her down into? She will become an accomplice to his criminal behavior. She'll become a moll, shot at by gangsters.
You have no say in this, Father.
We have made our decision.
And first and foremost on our list of restrictions is you keep your mouth shut. If you don't, I will allow AJ and Ned to send you off to jail for your various crimes and misdemeanors against Xander.
Oh, for heaven's sake.
Are you clear on that?
I am the patriarch of this family, and nobody values my opinions.
Grandfather, I'd like to say goodnight to my boyfriend. Would you like me to give him a kiss right here in front of you or at the front door?
This is absolutely preposterous. Giving Emily permission to kiss that deviant right before our very eyes.
What's that I hear? The sound of a jail cell.
Oh, come on, shut up.
They're watching every move we make.
I don't care. All I can see is you. Do you realize how long it's taken for us to get to this point?
Yeah, I do.
Hey, everyone. It's just a kiss. It's not like the eighth grade wonder of the world.
Can we just give him a little privacy here?
Oh, come on. The entire family watching. It kind of creates a nice intimate moment.
All be quiet, you two. Look. Come on, stay.
Well, I mean it.
You're so amazing.
So are you. Good night.
See you tomorrow.
Okay.
Yeah, it feels good to say that. Thank you.